Maybe you made our chocolate and hazelnut cake and you've got leftover egg whites and hazelnuts. What are you gonna do? Well, you're gonna make these hazelnut meringues. There are a ton of recipes where you use the yolks and you've got leftover egg whites. And how many egg white omelets do you wanna eat? For me, none. Here's what else you're gonna need. Toasted hazelnuts, sugar, white sugar, demerara sugar, ground cinnamon, cream of tartar, vanilla extract. So the first thing you're gonna do is take the hazelnuts, put them onto a baking sheet and pop that into a very hot oven. You just wanna toast them and bring out all of the hazelnutty flavor. It will also help to loosen the papery skins on the outside. And you wanna try and get rid of as many of those skins as possible. So once you take them out of the oven, put them into a clean tea towel. Pains me that I have to say clean tea towel. Wrap them up and shake them around, roll them around on the counter, and you wanna work off as much of that brown papery covering as you can. You won't get it all off. Don't worry if you can't, and it can be very messy. Put the hazelnuts into a food processor and just give them a rough chop. At this point, you want to take some of the hazelnuts out that are just roughly chopped. And then you want to grind the rest finely, but not to the point where they reach a nut butter. In a small bowl, mix together the white and brown sugar and the cinnamon. You just want to get that all mixed together. Now in the bowl of a stand mixer, and apparently I'm contractually obligated to tell you that this bowl needs to be impeccably clean. I think you already know that, but anyway, there's something about the fats and the oils that could be on the inside of that bowl that will keep the whites from beating up nicely. So you want to whisk those egg whites, and as soon as you start to get it frothy, add in a little bit of cream of tartar. If you don't have cream of tartar, don't worry about it. It's not strictly necessary. It helps, but without it, it's gonna be fine. Now with the machine still running, slowly spoon in the sugar. And when you've got about half of the sugar mixed in, you can start to spoon it in a little more quickly. Now you want to keep whisking those eggs until they look really glossy. You're going to notice a change from sort of a dull white to a very glossy, glossy, glassy white. Now at that point, you fold in both the ground and the chopped up hazelnuts and get that all nice and combined. Now you're ready to put these out onto a baking tray. Now, if you're trying to impress somebody, you'll put them into a piping bag and you'll pipe them out very carefully to get nice, perfectly round meringues. I'm not trying to impress anybody, I'm just trying to use up 5 egg whites that I have, and I really like meringues, so I don't really care what they look like. So I just use 2 spoons and as carefully as I can, scoop them onto the parchment paper lined baking sheets. Now you put those into a preheated low oven and it's gonna take about 90 minutes. You just want them to dry out. As much as you're cooking them, you're also drying them. Once that 90 minutes is up, you can turn off the oven and just leave the baking pans inside. As the oven cools, the meringues will continue to dry. And this is what you end up with. Sounds pretty nice. The shape isn't too bad. Very dry, light, fluffy. Oh my. That's amazing. That is amazing. I wish you could be here to have some of this with me. I'm kind of glad that you're not, because I get to eat them all. None for the crew. All these meringues are mine.